Hi, this is Sean, and this video is on UV texture sets. So in the past, you would, if you needed to do a texture on an object, you would go in and set up the UVs, which I've done already. So I've taken a UV planar map, I've created a planar map of these UVs, and then from there, that was it. You would sort of go into polygons and take a UV snapshot, and then you would apply textures to them. And so I have two textures that I sort of put together. Here's a brick texture, and here's a cobblestone texture. And then the deal is that you would take those textures and you would start to work them into this space. So I would maybe duplicate this layer again and start to make it, you know, and it would take some serious photoshopping work, and if I was lucky, I would get this much texture density in this area, and then I could go in and take this cobblestone, and I could sort of pack this in. And given the texture resolution here, 1024 by 1024, that would be the maximum texture resolution I could get. So, and it sort of defeats the purpose of having tileable textures. Texture is tileable when you can go into the 2D placement node in Maya on the layered shader here. And show the input and output connections. So here's the bricks. Now, with UV texture sets, you can go in and, you know, make the texture density as high as you want. Let's make this So here we go. We've got definitely a lot. I mean, you're actually starting to see the pattern in the bricks. It's so high. So we might take that down to like 4 and 4. Re-render. And it really gives you the flexibility of getting higher texture density on this object. So how do we do this? Well, you do need... the way I do it is you can use a layered shader, and on your object you start out, you have a base layer, a UV set. And where do you get the UV sets? You get the UV sets under the UV set editor. So you're always going to get the base set. And then what I do is I'll add geometry to an object and then just bring over the UVs for the UV set that I want to have cover the whole UV space, which is why then it works as a tileable texture. So in this case, I broke it down into a brick texture. So that would be just the area inside the brick area. And here's the cobblestone area. And that would be this here and this here. So there should be... two shells on top of each other. So let's go through the process. I have an additional plane ready for that, and let's build one. The final thing that you need to do is you definitely need some sort of transparency on your layered shader. So in this case, I've got concrete on top of the brick. So within the concrete shader, on the base layer, I need to put in a transparency. And in Photoshop, the way I would do that would be to create a transparency layer right in this area. So I'll show all that process as I go through and do this from scratch here. So, without further ado, let's go to it. I've got the UV texture editor open. Let's also pull open the UV set editor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create two sets. The first set I'll call brick. The second set I will call cobblestone. So for the brick set, And one thing you can do is you can also copy UVs into different sets. You can go under here and copy UVs to set brick. And so now if I look in the brick, here we go, I've got that. Just this UV in the brick set. And if I want to, then I could sort of take these UVs and stretch them out, and I wouldn't even have to do another planar map. And so that's what I'm going to do. If I go back to the map here, I'm going to select these UVs, and I'm going to copy those to the cobble set. Or I could just go to the blank cobble set and create new UVs. So, and I'll show that as a separate sort of workflow. So the other way is, I'm on the cobble set, it's completely empty. I'm going to select this panel here. I'll go under Create UVs, Planar Map. Got to make sure the planar map's facing the right way. It is. So I've completely filled the 0 to 1 space with just this panel. So I'm going to do that again. I'm going to hit the G key to repeat. And now I've got two overlapping shells. I'm going to create, assign favorite material, layered shader. And I've already built my brick texture, and I'm going to drag that in. And then I'm going to bring in my concrete shader. I'm going to get rid of this layer, and I can shuffle these layers by middle mouse and dragging, so the concrete will be the one that's on top. So let's see if I've got that working right. Concrete is on top. Great. So now, what do I need to do? Within the concrete shader, I need a transparency map. So let me break this connection. Background here. So I'm going to save this off as a PNG because that will hold the transparency. So let me hit Control Shift S, and I'm going to save this as a PNG file. So we'll call this cobble opacity. And so now if we go in back into Maya, we can plug that into the transparency channel. And so now you can see that that's working. Okay, so great. We've got that working now. How do I assign, or what do I need to do to get this all sort of set up and working correctly? Well, there's a, under Windows, Settings and Preferences, Relationship Editors, there's UV linking. And so I can do there's texture centric linking. So the way I would sort of do this is I would say that the transparency is to the correct channel. Let's check the cobble texture. I want that to go and apply to the cobble channel. So let's make sure that we've got that set up correctly. And then for the brick texture, drop that and make sure that goes into the brick channel. And that is what's going to allow us to accurately use the 2D placement node to get the correct kind of tiling that we want. It's this relationship editor. So that should just about do it. You can get very complicated with this, and as you can start to see that these file, like when you don't name your textures, it starts to get a little bit dodgy in terms of figuring out what to link to what UV set. But that's the basics for how to do it. I have a more complicated example. I built a hallway with, you know, four or five layered textures that I all created in Maya, and I'll be happy to show that in class. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.